ॐ सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहे तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहे। ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड द कर्म फॉर टॉरस जेमिनी एंड कैंसर। We will do three more signs today. So should we take Leo, Virgo, Libra or Aries, Pisces, Aquarius? What do you say? Should we go in the direct order or the opposite order or the reverse order? What's your opinion? Let me go in the direct order itself. The karma for Leo. What is the karma for Leo? I will do the karma for all the 12 signs, and then once I finish my nakshatra course, because in nakshatra course in the last few classes I have to teach karma. Once I complete my nakshatra course, I will start a separate course on karma also, a long course on karma, because karma is everything. Karma is the crux of any astrological reading. So the karma for Leo. Leo indicates a cave. And yesterday we learned about rock technique, the karma rock. Leo indicating a cave, a forest, generally indicates that the person focuses on a lot of things. That's his prime karma. He wants to do everything. And he should get rid of this tendency. His wish of doing everything, holding everything, being master at every place is the toughest challenge, the toughest karma that he should go through. The biggest karma for a Leo is to compromise his ego. You people must have heard that Magha indicates a throne. But is it a reality? No. Magha indicates a small bed without a backrest. That's what Magha is. A small bed without a backrest. It is not a throne. So the prime karma for a Leo person is accept to live without any authority, accept to live without any special rights, is to accept that you are not the superior one, to crush the ego. The guru, the Jupiter, is in the ninth house of Sagittarius, and the teaching of the guru, the higher learning of the guru, is ninth from the sign of Jupiter, and the ninth from the sign of Jupiter is Leo. And what the guru does first? Firstly, the guru will kill your ego. Sacrificing your ego is the biggest karma for a Leo person, and they will find it extremely difficult. Leo person will destroy every relationship in his life because of his funny ego, a small ego. They have a wall made up of requirements around them. And they cannot get over that wall. And that's the biggest problem. They make an invisible wall around themselves and they don't let anyone enter inside that wall. Be it their friend, their family member, anyone. They have an, you know, unknown sense of being watched. That someone is watching them. The Leo is highly suspicious. Living the suspicion, trusting even in a stranger who can harm you, letting people harm you, getting your ego challenged, crushing your ego, giving your ego away, is the biggest karma for a Leo person. Whichever house you have lived. Sorry?
Were you suspicious? Character kind of thing.
Why suspicious? Because they make a unknown wall around themselves. Lakshman is Leo Lagna.
Achha.
Lakshman Rekha is there.
Okay.
Lakshman Rekha is there in Leo.
Okay.
The Sheshnag is in Ashlesha. The avatar of Sheshnag is in Leo. Lakshman is the Sheshnag avatar. The Lakshman Rekha is there. Okay. That's a species.
Oh, please carry on.
They have to get rid of their ego. Yes, Vasudev, the lion marks boundaries. The karma to let people enter your personal space at the risk of being challenged is the karma for Leo. Whichever house Leo is in your horoscope, that house you have to compromise there. Leo is your seventh house. For Aquarius, you have to compromise on marriage. That's why for an Aquarius person, marriage is bad, because they have to compromise. You are an Aries Lagna, Leo is your fifth house. You have to compromise on accounts of children. That's what you have to do. Your children probably won't do what you want them to do. And you have to compromise there. The house where Leo is, that house constantly gives you an ego crush.
Sixth house
indicates enemies and everything. Enemies and disease and challenges and people working with you. So for the sixth house Leo person, you have to accept that even the people who are not the 1% of your knowledge or your power can also go further in life. And you have to accept the defeat, because sixth house is fight. So sixth house is more or less like accepting the defeat. You have to compromise on account that other person who is not that talented as you are can also go to a better position than you, and you have to accept it. That you cannot win always. That you can be defeated. For Leo in the sixth house, you should understand that for every share, there is a savashe. This is what my maternal uncle used to say me always. Har share ko savashe milta hai. Right. That's the karma. Leo. Coming to the next sign, Virgo. What is the karma for Virgo? Anything that you can tell me about Virgo? What do you think should be the karma of Virgo?
Breaking your virginity?
Losing your virginity, that is a thing, yes. You have to lose something that you have saved all these years. Lose it in a second.
And you have to guide others?
Guide others is quite okay. Will not agree with that.
You have to serve others.
You have to serve others. Yes, we can take a survey. Yeah. We can take a survey. The first important thing is you have to accept that the things that you have preserved over a lifetime can get destroyed also. Certainly get destroyed. It will certainly get destroyed. What do you think that the lady in the Virgo is a very beautiful lady? Very good lady, good looking lady.
No. Sylvia, dirty kind.
She is a dirty lady who spits everywhere. That's what Jyotishmati says, that she's a dirty lady engrossed in complete dust, filthy, spitting here and there. That's what the Virgo lady is. The karma for Virgo is to embrace the fallen one. What the biggest karma for a Virgo is that you know that your child is bad. that you know that your child have done the crime, but you have to embrace it. You cannot get go away with it. Teda hai par mera hai. It is yours at the end of the day. You have to accept it. For a work person, you know that he is a criminal, but you have to have him in your company. You cannot leave him. That's the karma for work. You have to accept it no matter what is happening, no matter how bad it is. You have to accept it. It is the home of the Rajkumar. Rajkumar will do many mistakes, but the king have to accept it because he is the only one who is going to take the throne. If you kick the Rajkumar out, the throne will be empty and the enemies will take over you. So you have to compromise with something that's not worthy because you have the only option left. Virgo presents you with only one option. You know what? Whichever house you have Virgo, only one signification of the house you can enjoy. Other significations you cannot. It's only one thing that you can take, not many. Virgo is a sign that indicates duality. You think so. I never take Virgo as a dual sign. If you see my post, I never take Virgo as a dual sign. It is not a dual sign. It is a singular sign. It indicates one thing only. You can only take one thing from a Virgo. You cannot take multiple things.
And what is that?
That depends on multiple factor. Which planet is there? Which Navamsha is there? No, that is multiple factor. Multiple factor dependent. In astrology, there are very few patterns. You know, there are many times astrology is not governed by a pattern, because having a pattern means the thing is repetitive. And if the thing becomes repetitive, it will lose its charm. So it cannot be repetitive anytime. So at the end, it all boils down to planets and rashis and nakshatras and navamsha and whatnot. Jyotish have multiple criteria and multiple factors that we have to adhere to while doing an analysis. For a Gemini person, the fourth house is Virgo. I have a Gemini father. I know many people. My father is a Gemini. I have a Gemini client also. My Gemini client is a female lady. And she is not in the class. I'm very sure that she is going to see the recording. I will send the recording to her. You can choose one. The fourth house indicates mother, or you becoming a mother. This is one of my greatest technique. It is very simple. It will sound very simple, but let me tell you, fourth house doesn't only indicate your mother. It also indicates your chances of being a mother. Ninth house doesn't only indicate your father, it indicates your chances of being a father also. So if the ninth is gone, no matter how good the fifth is, your chances of being a father is very less. In that scenario, if you are having a child, I am highly suspicious that it is your child or not. Because you are not having a chances probably. So have to do a prashna for your child at least. And in this high level society, this prashna is quite common. All the big businessmen I have given consultations to, they have this prime question: sir, is it my child? I mean, you people are so suspicious. That happens with everyone. That happened with my father. Fourth house is there. He had to choose either the comfort or the tradition. He chose the spiritual tradition. He lost all the comfort. My father doesn't live a very comfortable life. You have to choose one. And you know what? In Virgo, Venus is debilitated. And you know what is the problem with Venus? Venus governs the Mrit Sanjeevani Vidya. You will always have a regret that I had the power to save it, but I was not able to. If you are having Virgo in your fourth house, you will always have a regret that I had a chance to save this home, save this family, but it was my mistake. I was not able to do it. The things will slip out of your hand and you will not be able to control it. That was Virgo is. She's on a boat. You know, I will always say one thing about Virgo. You remember a very good saying, right? Hame to apno ne mara gehron mein kaha tum tha. Hamari kasti wahan doobi jahan pani kam tha. The Virgo indicates a boat on a river side. It is not a boat in the sea. It is on a river side. Pani kam tha. In wahi kasti dube.
Fantastic, fantastic.
Virgo is a daldal. Daldal ko kya kehte English mein? Mujhe nahi pata. Virgo is a daldal. Marshy land. England. Marshy land. Once you put your feet in the Virgo, you are not able to take your feet out. It is a consequent chain of karma. You have to activate it once, and it is a chain reaction. It's like atom bomb. You will put a pin, and things is gone. You told your child once that you do anything, I'm your father, I will support you. And then he will come after, having his car go over the sleeping people on the road, and then you have to accept it. One mistake you do and Virgo will not forget you. Because Venus is debilitated. Guru is debilitated. Venus is one of the Guru. And Guru is debilitated there. Karma is quite hard. The Guru is angry. The right guidance is not there. Virgo people don't have right guidance in their life. Biggest problem that they suffer. Libra. What do you think is the problem with Libra? Namaste Neha ji, namaste. What do you think is the problem with Libra? What is the problem with Deepavali? What is bad with Deepavali? Tell me four things about Deepavali, come on. One thing let me tell you. My maternal grandmother always used to tell me, Deepavali to choron ki raat. Deepavali is for thieves, not for good people. The three more things about Deepavali. Why is Deepavali celebrated?
Celebrated on Amavasya.
Celebrated on Amavasya, right.
Sun debilitated.
Sun debilitated, yeah. That's
so next day, moon is also debilitated.
The next day, moon is also debilitated. The biggest
betting jua khelna
jua satta to ha. Why Deepavali celebrated? The fundamental question.
Lord Rama came on this particular day,
came back from exile,
right?
So you have to go to exile first. You made a home after much, much hard work, and then your child throws you in an old age home. Taking everything from you, it is cheating. Jua is for cheating. It is the night of the thieves. The bad will also get over you. And you being a good person will have nothing. Because it is a businessman sign. And in business, the honest people will suffer a lot. The bad one will not suffer. You have to go through the exile, that is the problem. But you know what is the biggest problem that happened after Rama came back? A dhobi is accusing his wife.
But aapne ek baat kahi thi ki Ramayan mein ye likha tha ki ye jo baat ka jo Uttarkhand hai, मतलब रामचरितमानस का वो बाद में जोड़ा गया है, तो लेकिन जब रामायण पढ़ते हैं तो जैसे वो अयोध्या में आते हैं फिर वो मतलब उसके बाद खत्म हो जाता है कि वो 11,000 साल तक उन्होंने राज किया।
They have different, there are different opinions, different editions. Kamb Ramayan don't have a Uttarkhand as I remember well. Right, so there are different parts of the story. Manas is not the real Valmiki version. Valmiki version says something else. Manas says something else. Manas is more poetic and emotional, whereas the original Ramayana is not. And there are different versions of Ramayana. I have read the 300 versions of Ramayana I have heard of. So that is a scholarly debate, that whether the Uttarakhand is added later on or not. My basic point is that exile. From that exile, you have to come. So that exile you have to suffer. And you know what? That exile was a big loss for Ram. He was not even able to attend the funeral of his father. Some person will come and accuse your wife, and in the shame, you have to do a suicide. You have to commit suicide. That's what Rama did, right? Rama did suicide. Rama died of a suicide. And how the Lanka was born? A brother is giving you a tip on how to kill his brother. Libra is not a happy family. Don't imagine. The biggest problem. What? Why do you work? I ask you a very fundamental question. Why do you work? Do you work for yourself? Am I working for myself? Do you think that I need to do a class every Saturday and Sunday just for my own stomach? Come on, no. I'm a Jyotish, I can sit with a parrot on a road and I will get food. That's quite common. If I'm asking you people food, you people will be very happy to give me. Every day I can go to a new home and eat food. And whatever I desire, you will ask, sir, what you want to eat, paneer, murga, maas, jo bolo. The biggest thing that for the biggest thing for which you do everything is your family. And because the sun is debilitated there, your authority in the family is challenged always. For a Libra person, the biggest problem is that outsiders will come and will tell your family person to do something, and your family person will follow the outsider, not you. Such a pathetic scenario. You did everything for the prestige, but sun is debilitated. The prestige will be gone, causing you shame. That's the problem with Libra. Libra is a businessman, right? Which type of businessman it is? A big industrialist sitting on a rocking chair like I am sitting on this rocking chair right now. Is it like that? No. Libra is a hawker who takes things in his hand, things in one hand, the balance in the other hand, and goes on yelling at the streets. Aloo le lo, dhaniya le lo. That is what Libra is. Hawker. No matter how rich a Libra person is, once in a lifetime he have to beg. Be ready for that begging. You know, Yavaneshwar says that Aquarius is a very unfortunate person. Why Yavaneshwar will say that 80% of the sages are of the opinion that Aquarius is a very unfortunate sign? Why it is a very unfortunate sign? What is bad with the fortune of Aquarius?
Libra comes in 9th.
Libra comes in 9th house. His fortune is to beg. That's his fortune. That's what makes Saturn a menial person. That's what makes person a servant. Even for the things that he deserves, he has to beg. Because of some or the reasons. The authority, the sun is debilitated there. Your authority is challenged. I did everything for a student. And he and then he will say, what you have given me? Like, of course, nothing. That's what you have to do with Libra.
Same is true for the luck. If suppose it is Lagna or Chandra Rashi, so it can be interpreted as this.
Yes. See, the confusion between the Lagna and the Chandra Rashi, let me clear it for once. I'm writing an article on it, but I'm not getting much time to finish it. The article is 80% ready, 20% left out. The basic traditional dictum, the first dictum that we are taught in the tradition is to find the stronger between Lagna and Moon. Four rules to find the stronger between Lagna and Moon. I have included all the four rules in the article. Once you decide stronger between Lagna and Moon, you have to use that reference for every prediction under the sun. And the other reference is just another reference. Just for cross-checking. The prime reference is the basic reference. So Lagna and Moon have the same importance. Just you have to check which one is stronger. Many times it will happen that person will have a certain Lagna, but the result of the Lagna is not coming. many people will say, sir, I have said in the fourth house the result is not matching, and I don't answer it why it is not matching. Who knows your moon is more strong then? So first is
लेकिन जब चंद्र राशि को अगर हम अपनी लग्न बना लेते हैं तो जो आप बताते हैं कि दशा, वो मुझे इतना नहीं उसका आइडिया है, जो आप बहुत जल्दी कर देते हैं आप उसको विंडो पे, वो जो दशा आप चूज करते हैं, तो जैसे हम लग्न से जब निकालते हैं तो मून का जो नक्षत्र है उससे निकालते हैं, तो जब हम चंद्र राशि को अपनी लग्न बना लेंगे तो हम किस नक्षत्र को लेंगे फिर?
चंद्र राशि और लग्न में से बलि डिसाइड करने का फॉर्मूला अलग है, और दशा का शुरू करते हैं उसका फॉर्मूला अलग है। दो अलग अलग फॉर्मूला, सेम फॉर्मूला नहीं, टू डिफरेंट फॉर्मूला।
सॉरी, ये फोन आ गया था इसलिए
मैं रिपीट करता हूँ। हु इज स्ट्रॉन्गर बिटवीन लग्न एंड मून टू डिसाइड इट, देयर आर डिफरेंट सेटअप रूल्स।
वो ठीक है, वो डिसाइड हो गया।
फ्रॉम वेयर टू स्टार्ट द दशा इज अ डिफरेंट सेटअप रूल। So there are two different set of rules.
Okay.
तो दोनों रूल को डिसाइड करके अपने अलग अलग रूल है, अलग अलग रूल से डिसाइड। एक्चुअली इन वैदिक ज्योतिष देर आर मल्टीपल रूल्स एंड वी कैन नॉट अप्लाई एवरी रूल अंडर द सन। सो द थर्ड डे इन माई ट्रेडिशन, द थर्ड बिगेस्ट थिंग दैट आई वॉज टॉट इन द ट्रेडिशन वॉज एवरी रूल इज नॉट एवरी टाइम लिमिटेशन। सर्टन रूल इज टू बी यूज फॉर अ सर्टन टाइम। Digbal is only used in Vimshatri Dasha. Kalbal is only used in Astrotri Dasha. Drigbal is only used in Shodashatri Dasha. So special rules are used at different time. Bhai, you cannot stitch a cloth using a sword. Different tools for different thing, right? So there are multiple set of rules. You cannot use every rule haphazardly.
सर फिर प्रमोट भी कर दो ना, दशा का कोर्स हैंडल कर रहे हैं उसके लिए।
क्या
पॉइंट मिल, जस्ट प्रमोट द आवर दशा को।
आखिरी आधा घंटा रखा है उसके लिए वसंत जी, आखिरी आधा घंटा में सोच के बैठा
हूं। नहीं, अभी विपुल जी ने अपने को मौका दिया, उस पेन दिया है इसके लिए दशा कोर्स है।
यस यस यस। सो देयर आर मेनी डिस्क्रिपेंसीज विद दशास। अच्छा, आई विल एक्सप्लेन। I did it in Dasha Veda 1.1 video also. I will explain it, but let me finish this Rashi one, okay? Because then video will get intermixed and we'll do it. So the karma for the Libra is quite clear, right? So we'll stop here.